News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me today is Catherine. Hi there, Catherine.
Hi, Neil.
What's our story?
Today's story is about an illness that we usually only hear about in the history books.
Right, an historical illness. Let's find out a little bit more from this BBC World Service News Bulletin.
Doctors in Australia are blaming poor modern diets for a rise in the number of people suffering from scurvy. The disease has been diagnosed in 7 diabetic patients in Sydney.
So our story today comes from Sydney, Australia, where doctors have been seeing patients with a disease called scurvy. Now, scurvy is caused by a lack of vitamin C, and we find vitamin C in fruits like oranges and lemons. And in the past, sailors on very long sea voyages, months at a time, would get scurvy because they didn't know how to prevent it. But you don't really hear about scurvy these days. It's a horrible disease. It's very, very painful and unpleasant. So it's a surprise to see it happening at the moment. And the doctors in Australia say it's because of poor diet. People aren't eating the right fruit and vegetables, although these patients also have diabetes, which means you have to watch what you have to be careful what you eat. So that may be a factor.
OK, well, you've been researching this story and looking around at the various news websites. What's the language that you've chosen?
OK, so we have 3 words today. The first one is comeback. The second word is resurgence. And our third word today is archaic.
OK, so that first headline, please.
So from the Telegraph, we have scurvy makes comeback in Australia as dietary habits worsen.
So come back, a return of something after a period of time.
Yep. And it's really simple formation of the word. You get the word come back, put them together, and you have come back.
As a noun.
Come back as a noun. We could also use it as with the verb make. So you can make a comeback, and we can also put it together with another noun to have something like a comeback concert or a comeback tour.
Right. So have you got an example of a comeback concert?
I have. Michael Jackson hadn't done any concerts for quite a long time. So there was a period when he wasn't doing anything. Then he planned a comeback concerts here in London, but unfortunately, as we know, he died while he was rehearsing for his comeback or his comeback concerts.
Next, we have the word resurgence.
We do. And if we're now to look at ABC, we have doctor at Sydney Hospital discovers scurvy resurgence due to poor dietary habits.
So a resurgence is the start of something again, which used to happen. So very similar to comeback.
It's got a very, very similar meaning. I think the main difference between resurgence and comeback is that resurgence is more formal. Mm-hmm. You won't say it in your everyday speech. We don't talk about Michael Jackson's resurgence concert.
No.
But it has the same meaning.
Mm. It's also got a sense of sort of gathering pace of activity.
Yes, yes, yes. So the word surge in the middle of resurgence has... Surge means a kind of forceful increase in something,
And the preposition use is quite interesting because you've got a couple of options for a change.
Yes, yeah, you can have a resurgence in something or a resurgence of something. There's very little difference between the two. Generally speaking, you can have a resurgence in scurvy or a resurgence of scurvy. Choose the one you want. There's no problem with that.
All right, and our third item of vocabulary.
Okay, so moving on to the Sydney Morning Herald, where we have scurvy surprise, archaic sickness that struck down sailors resurfaces in Sydney.
Archaic. Archaic meaning old, belonging to the distant past.
Very distant past, strictly speaking. So the arc in archaic is the same arc as the arc in archaeology.
Mm-hmm.
So it means from a long, 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 long time ago in history. And usually, because it's so old, it isn't used today or it doesn't exist today.
Quite a formal word.
Yeah, most definitely. It works really well in this headline because it really summarises that the scurvy is from the past. We haven't had it for a long time. So it's a really good word to say, why is it here now? Because it's from the past, yeah.
Now, I've got a really bad mobile phone.
Another, have you?
Which people make jokes about.
I think I've seen that phone.
And they say to me, Neil, this thing is archaic. What are you doing with this phone? Now, that's not ancient technology. So why are they saying archaic?
It's a really good use of the word. And we use it archaic in a kind of jokey way, sometimes in a slightly insulting way to say it's old. There are better ones available. Mm-hmm. It's not the technology that we use anymore. It looks old-fashioned. It works in an old-fashioned way. So, yeah, archaic is slightly insulting. You can also talk about archaic systems. Uh-huh. So if you have an office that's using a lot of paper, whereas another office would use lots of technology, IT, you could say they have an archaic system in the office. Might not be really old, but it feels so old that it's no longer the right thing to use.
Well, we're not archaic, are we, Catherine?
We're not archaic, Neil, apart from your telephone.
Okay, before we recap what we've looked at today, we've got the Facebook challenge. We've been discussing scurvy. A disease caused by a lack of vitamin C. British sailors used to eat a certain type of fruit to make sure they didn't get this disease, scurvy, and it led to an insulting name, which Americans used to call British people, or maybe they still do, but I think it's more in the past. Was that name A, lemony, B, limey, or C, orangey? What did we get?
We got lots of answers on Facebook, as always. Almost everybody chose a correct answer. So well done to Marwa Gamal, Sue Sandy Tun, and Nitty Indy, and everybody else who said B, limey. Limey is the word that Americans used to use to insult English people, British people.
Okay, then just time now for our recap.
Yes. We had comeback, which means a return of something after a period of time. We had resurgence, the start of something again, which used to happen. And archaic, meaning old and belonging to the past.
If you would like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz that you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all sorts of other materials, videos, audio recordings to help you improve your English. And it's goodbye from a couple of limeys.
Goodbye from a couple of limeys.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.